I thank the organizers for continuing this very nice work so for very long. So I'll be talking about clipped linear interfaces, and this is related to self-organized criticality. I will make a relation between self-organized criticality and these clipped interfaces. Okay, so I'll when I go along, I'll explain you what do I mean by clipped interfaces. So as you know, that there are many talks, and that critical point is associated with scale invariance or power loss. Okay, so basically there is a tuning parameter you tune, and at some point you have this divergence of susceptibility or specific heat. Okay, so these are power loss. But in nature, actually, there are many events, many examples where criticality occurs without any tuning parameter. Okay, so one example is earthquakes. So there are a lot of earthquakes, and if you take the event size and make a plot histogram of that, and you see a power law, it's called, for earthquake, it's called Gutenberg law, and this is what we call one particular thing which you call self-organized criticality. And there are very interesting stuff. For example, when this is a mouse which is asleep, and when it wakes up, you can see that there is a power law in the patches in the brain. Like, if you look at the events, so this is second mouse, third mouse. So when they wake up, you can see that there is a power law there. So what happens is that, if you want to explain this phenomena, power laws are things where you have sporadic large events. Okay, so. So what we want to model is that the sporadic large events and sand piles or rice piles show similar behavior. So for example, if you take just start dropping grains, sand grains here, then after some time it will make a conical shape, and then if you drop a grain on the pile, it will make some disturbances, and sometimes the disturbances is very small, but if you drop one more grain, the disturbances can be as large as the system size. Okay, if you take a bigger one, it will still propagate to the system, all through the system. So this is kind of a scale invariant property, and this is a critical property. So and the experiments are done also in Oslo, so this is called Oslo rice piles. Okay, so and if you look at the events, like the burst of activity, so and you find this kind of sporadic large events, and you plot them, you see power loss. So now to model sand piles, we the model which you take is called Oslo rice pile model, and let me explain how you model this Oslo rice pile. Okay, so you have a lattice, one dimensional lattice, and there are particles. So if a some site has more than one particle, which means two or more, then these particles, that the sites are called active. So active sites tuple. Okay, so if n greater than 2, that site will tuple. Like this is the color ones are active. So I'm saying that this will not tuple. Okay, so n equal to 2. So if it is greater than 2, it will always tuple. If equal to 2, it tuples with probability p. Okay, so for example, this will not tuple. Decide it is 2, so decides not to tuple. So here it will tuple twice. These two particles will tuple. These two will also tuple. So basically, two particles go to the left from here, two to the right, and two remains here. So that's kind of one tuple event. Okay. So now you want to find out what people look for in such models. So here how you study is that you have a one-dimensional lattice. When everywhere you have inactive, all sites are inactive, which means less than two or less particles, and that's the inactive sites. You drop a grain somewhere here, somewhere in this system, and wait, like the sand grains, it will create some activity. Just measure the activity and make a histogram, they will show power law. Here, you can see a power law over 10 decades or something, okay? So what do you measure? You measure the activity, or how many sites are activated by a single grain, or you can measure the duration. How long the activity survives, it will just keep activating the system, and both of them show power law. There are other things which also show power law. So now question is that, this is a critical systems, and in criticality, that there are universality classes. So what you want to find out is that what is the universality class of this self-organized critical systems, and there is a lot of debate. what is the generic, most generic critical or universality class of that? So the debate is divided into two kind of, you know, debate basically means at least there is two opinions. So what it says is that, you know, maybe if you look at the sand file, if you drop a grain, it is unstable. It will make that neighbors unstable. They will make their neighbor unstable. So this is just a propagation process. It's like infection. Like, you know, somebody who is infected, it will infect their neighbors. The neighbors will infect their neighbors. So, and this infection process is something, yeah, the battery is gone here. Yeah, so this infection process is something which you know as directed percolation. So there are a lot of works in this direction saying that this critical behavior must be directed percolation, okay? So there are other set of people who actually disagree with this. And the argument is that, you know, because there is an additional conservation law here, because when particles go, like, you know, locally, the particles don't go out of the system, there is a local conservation. So the critical behavior could be some other class that's called conserved directed percolation or Manna class, okay? And there is a lot of work in this direction, and this has been a very long debate, and I'll try to tell you some of the debates. I think, so some of the things I will skip. So first thing we study is the sticky grain models. We say that maybe there are these sand piles, if you perturb the sand piles, you can get this DP behavior. So recently we find that the sand piles, the critical state of the sand piles are pretty slow, and you can see that it's a very long time it becomes flat, so probably they're DP. So this is one work. And so this kind of states which are called hyperuniformity. So recently people find that this critical absorbing states, it's not on sand piles, all critical absorbing states are hyperuniform. So people support this recently, you know, 2015, this idea that the slowness is being supported. But then there are other works which talks of field theory, okay? So what you have is that you have, you know, this is a activity field, like, you know, this is like a directed percolation. And just because there is a background, you have a conserved background field. So this is the background field, and there is some coupling. So you get, so this is the equation for what you call Manna class, okay? And then there is a, you know, this paper recently actually map Manna class to something which you called Edward Wilkinson model. So that's what the mapping is. So, and then there are other things. So this goes into the debate, and the reason for the confusion is, you know, if your numerics gives you for the same exponent, different models give you this kind of exponent, so it's DP or not DP, that's the question, okay? So what we try to start here is that we say that Oslo model, I think I talked about this, I don't have, we recently study what you call clipped interface models, so which is given by this. So you take a diffusion equation, okay, and if you take a discrete space-time, this diffusion equation would look like replace a site by sum of their average of the neighboring sites. So this is average, this is average half, this is average half. You keep doing, and these two averages again half, these two averages three-fourth. If you go like that in a lattice, you know, it will homogenize the system, and that's called diffusion. Okay, so what you do extra on the top of it, you say that, let us say that you want to keep only integers. Okay. So when you want to keep integers, so now here there is a half integer. So if you get a half integer, you add plus half or minus half, okay, with some probability. And if you get an integer, you put add plus one or minus one, or don't do anything, add zero, okay? So that's the way you do it. And the clip comes out here, because if it is zero, it remains zero with probability one. So that's the clip. So this is an interface model which grows, but you don't allow the surface to grow, you know, to below. So now the question is, what do you want? So, you know, what is the kind of phase diagram in this? So you can see that there are three parameters, because when it is odd, the input is odd, like this two is odd, then this is P half or P minus half, and there are two equations, like three parameters. So there are three parameters, okay? So in the three parameters, and you know that P minus one and P, so we take the three parameters P0, P1. So P0 plus P1 has to be less than one, that is a triangle. And P half can take 0 to 1. That's the probabilities, okay? So the phase, you know, the full phase space looks like a prism, okay? So in this prism, because you are, you know, now it's not diffusion, you are adding particles and you are also deleting particles, okay? So now, if your probability of adding is more, then the surface actually can grow to infinity, okay? So the whole prism actually has two parts. One part where, you know, it just goes to 0. Other part, the surface goes to infinity. So there is a surface which actually divides this one to what you call finite avalanche versus infinite avalanche, and you want to study the critical behavior of this, okay, this surface. And it turns out there is a variety of critical behavior in the surface, and these are the things which you study numerically. So there are, this point is like Domanik-Pinzel line, and this one is what you know, this Manna model or Oslo model, and this one is a very new universality class. This is this part is KPG, and this one is compact-directed population. So we have a variety of universality classes which are coming out from a simple model. And so the conclusion, and these are the exponents, and the conclusion is that probably stochastic sandpiles exhibit many universality, and directed populations appears to be a most robust universality. But if you look at the phase diagram, because these are unstable, they flow to DP, and there is a triangle is a new fixed point which is not studied until now in the self-organized systems or absorbing transitions. Okay, absorbing transitions or self-organized systems, this phase is not being studied. And you have clipped KPG, clipped Edward Wilkinson, and that's it. Clipped Edward Wilkinson, no. Yes, another one. Yeah. So I'll click.
Any more questions? If not, let's thank the speaker then.